the last person, number 13, Rihanna, is someone who's passing made an impact not only on dancers and admirers of his, but I think on people all over the world. And that's Fred Astaire. Unfortunately, due to Mr. Astaire's death, Mrs. Astaire was unable to be here. And it's, I think, most fitting that friends and acquaintances of Fred's are here to accept on his behalf. And who better to do that than Mr. and Mrs. Whitney, Sonny and Mary Lou. And after that, so it, I'm noted here, we're asked to join in the opening of the newest gallery at the museum here, Shaping the American Dance Dream, the founders. So it's a great pleasure that I present to you Mr. and Mrs. C.V. Whitney, Sonny and Mary Lou.
I'll be very brief, but I did want to say something. Fred was a longtime friend of mine, and he himself said that I was his oldest friend in the United States. He was an amazing fella in many ways. Now, when my cousin Jock Whitney, John Hay, Jock Whitney and I saw him out in Hollywood and his stuff, we said, why in the world doesn't someone take that guy and put him on Broadway? So it was my cousin Jock and I that financed and got him on Broadway, and that time he was with his sister Adele in their first play, and that's when they made their great success on Broadway. Now Fred was Jock and I really were responsible for his making his great success in the theater. He never forgot it. In this way, every year on my birthday since that time, which was in the 30s, he calls me on the telephone. He somehow or other finds out where I am, and I might as well be in Timbuktu or whatnot. He calls me on the telephone to wish me a happy birthday and a nice new year. Well, you couldn't find a nicer thing to do than that for someone who, that makes me feel that my cousin Jock and I did a lot to help him in his career. I thank you.
I know that was difficult for my husband because they were very good friends, and he was saying this morning, you know, when I'm next year on February, when I'm 89 years old, Fred won't be calling me, but we'll think of him and we'll know that he's there. I just want to say that it gives me great pleasure to accept this award for Fred Astaire, a good friend of my husband's and a friend of mine. Fred Astaire gave more pleasure to more people in the 20th century than anyone. His magic was his utterly, invariably graceful dancing, which still and always today through television captivates even our younger generations who never saw him perhaps in a movie, let alone on the stage. Other film stars were more handsome, more romantic, more athletic, more imposing, but none of them, actually none of them, to an age like the 1980s, which honors style, it is most appropriate that he is being honored today. No one has equaled his style of dance. He was to me simply the best. And I want to thank all of you for coming, and I wonder now if you would follow me through that door. I'd like to invite all of you to the Hall of Fame, where we'll have a ribbon-cutting ceremony and see the wonderful work of Marty Bronson. Thank you.